Hello, my name is Emily Foster. I'm a social work student interning at the Center for Jewish Genetics. I'm working on the DNA Day Illinois 2013 project. This year will mark the sixth year the Center and the Illinois Department of Public Health have worked together on DNA Day Illinois. DNA Day takes place in April every year and is celebrated nationally. This year, the National DNA Day will be celebrated on April 25th, 2013. It is a celebration of advancements in genetics and its impact on our lives. In Illinois, we see DNA Day as a rallying point for the importance of family health history and newborn screening. Family health history can aid in diagnosis and risk assessment and in uncovering the potential need for genetic testing and counseling. Newborn screening is touted as a public health success story as it identifies the possibility of having a genetic disorder in thousands of infants each year. In addition to focusing on the importance of family health history and newborn screening, this year's project will give attention to informing patients and providers about the disorders that are being added to newborn screening in our state. 7 lysosomal storage disorders, as well as severe combined immune deficiency, will be added to screening of newborns. Screening for critical congenital heart defects is also becoming more routine in Illinois. The importance of newborn screening is critical. It can prevent permanent damage to a child or even death. While newborn screening celebrates its 50th anniversary this year, many nurses and much of the public are unaware of this critical service and its impact on families. Public health nurses that have some knowledge about these disorders can play an integral role in educating patients and in providing referral for follow-up testing, referral to specialists, coordination of care, and supporting caregivers. Providing educational materials to expectant parents and new caregivers is also of great importance. This year's project will provide information to public health nurses in a variety of formats: printed materials, updates to the EasyLearn Genetics website, as well as a webinar in which a licensed genetic counselor will present. We will also be providing a list of ideas for activities that clinics can conduct at their sites to celebrate DNA Day 2013. Printed materials for patients will also be sent to nurses to distribute at their sites and in their communities. We will be continuing to reach out to nurses throughout the year and will be providing more details about educational activities, opportunities, and resources soon. If you have any questions about the DNA Day Illinois 2013 project, please visit us at easylearngenetics.net. Thank you for your commitment to improving health outcomes in your communities.